Daddy, everyone, oh God, that is watching, oh God, from all over the world, Lord, we ask, oh God, that you touch them, oh God, this morning. I ask, oh God, that your mercy will locate everyone. Everyone, oh God, who has a desired heart, oh God, with expectation. That, oh God, that you turn, oh God, their story to glory this morning. That we pray, Lord Jesus, that you do a new thing in our midst. That, oh God, that the ears of men, oh God, we tingle. Bako zo daba ki di kado daba. Zuda bake de debo kabake de kadaba di. Zadabo ko bake ke debo daba ki de ke. Lord, as we praise and as we worship you, Lord, we ask that your glory will come down. That even as your Son, oh God, will be ministering to us and praying, oh God, that we pray, Lord Jesus, lives will be turned around, Lord. That the Lord will remember today for good in our life. That your God, it will be a day that we not forget in the haste in our life. In the name of Jesus, it will be a remarkable season, a remarkable time, Lord. That your God, in the diary and the calendar of our time. In the name of Jesus, Lord, Lord, Babako Zadaba, Zika Bakodo, Kadiba Kudide, Zeke Debo, Dabadi, Da Kukabake De. Zadebo kubade de kaku kabakida zekado di baki de kede bodo badi kake da badaba zadebo de bade kake de boko bakida kadi bodo badi kake daba. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. I want you to pray again and say, Lord, in your mercy, open the book of remembrance for me this morning. In your mercy, open the book of remembrance. Open a book of remembrance for me. Lord, I pray for everyone, oh God, that is under the unction of my voice, Lord, this morning. Daddy, Lord, as you begin with us this morning, I pray, Lord, you open a book of remembrance for everyone. Wherever we have been rejected, wherever we've been forgotten, we have only been known for that story, that unpleasant story that people have known, not with Lord, Baba, Lord, as you begin to bring that glory from there this morning. Lord, I pray you open, oh God, a book of remembrance for everyone. Daddy, remember everyone, oh God, Daddy, remember everyone in their marriages. Remember everyone, oh God, concerning their children. Remember everyone concerning their destiny, concerning their business and their ministry. Lord, concerning their relationship, Lord, concerning their health, I pray you remember. Lord, you remember everyone in every area, oh God, where they have been forgotten, or where they thought they have been forgotten, where men have neglected them. I pray, Lord Jesus, a book of remembrance be opened this morning. In the name of Jesus, let it book of remembrance be open. Thank you, blessed Redeemer, for in Jesus' name we have prayed. Lord, we want to say thank you. We give you all the praise. We worship you. We commit the service, Lord, in your hand. We pray that you come and take preeminence. Thank you for what you have been doing on this platform. Thank you for healings that have been taking place. Thank you for deliverance. Thank you, God, for fruitfulness. Thank you for divine conception that will be happening. Lord, we pray, Lord, that this morning you do a new thing. Daddy, we declare the service open in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. Welcome to service one more time. The Lord will bless as we praise and worship him this morning. I pray the Lord is going to locate you wherever you are in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is awesome. It's another wonderful.
Hallelujah.
How much again for us together in this eternal family. I believe it's going to do something new in your lives in this edition of this program in the name of Jesus. I just want us to do this. You know, when you come into the presence of this greatest tradition, it's not just I can speak it. Worship you, we exalt you. There is none like you. There is none to be compared with you. You are worthy. Glory. 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 For you are glory. And what is you are the upon the throne. And all to you, and we lift our voice in prayer. You are the Lamb upon the throne. For you are the Lord. We are everybody to be great. You are the Lamb. Walk on the throne. And to you, we lift our voice. You are the Lamb. Walk on the throne.
You got time Oh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Ebenezer, you are the mighty majesty, you are the Lord. Forevermore, Jehovah is Jehovah heaven is up. You are the mighty God. We give you glory, all the power, majesty. You are the Lord. Forevermore, say, oh, say, we give you glory, all the power, majesty. You are the Lord. Forevermore, Jehovah Shaman, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Ebenezer, you are the mighty God. We give you glory, honor, power, majesty, you are the Lord. Forevermore, Jehovah Shaman, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Ebenezer, you are the mighty God. We give you glory, the power, majesty, you are the Lord. Forevermore, Jehovah Shaman, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Ebenezer, you are the mighty God. We give you glory, the power, majesty, you are the Lord. Forevermore, we bless all the Lord. God has lifted me above my enemies. Your banner over me is love. I will desert thee, Lord, for thou hast lifted me above my enemies. Your banner over me is love. Let's all be long, for thou hast lifted up above my enemies. Your banner over us is love. I will let all be long, for thou hast lifted me above my enemies. Your banner over me. I will exalt thee, King, for thou hast lifted me, oh, above my enemies, Lord. Your banner over me is love. I will lift up your name. I will lift up your name. I will lift up your name. Above every other name, I will lift up your name, King of glory. I will lift up your name. I will lift up your name. Above every other name, I will lift up your name, Jehovah. I will lift up your name. Oh. I will lift up your name above every other name. Oh God, we will lift up your name above situation. We will lift up your name, Jehovah. We will lift up your name above every other name. Baba, oh, I will lift up your name. I will lift up your name above every other name. Yeah. We will lift up your name for your goodness. We will lift up your name for your kindness. We will lift up your name above every other name. Baba, oh, we will lift up your name. Ah, we will lift up your name. Oh, we will lift up your name. Above every other name, Daddy, we will bless your holy name. Mama, we will bless your holy name. Oh, we will bless up your name. above every other name. This kind God, oh, I never see a type. This kind God, oh, blessed be your holy name. This kind God, oh, I never see a type. This kind God, oh, blessed be your holy name. Hey, this kind God, oh, you know, we never see your time. This kind God, oh, blessed be your holy name. Hey, this kind King, oh, come out, we never see your time. This kind King, oh, blessed be your holy name. Oh, this kind God, I never see your time. This kind God, oh, blessed be your holy name.
Let us sing of rejoicing in the light.
me. I can not like this. What no man can do. Hey, hallelujah. Hey, with the sound of victory, he has done for me. What no man can do. Let the sound of rejoicing in my life. He has done for me. He has done for us. What no man can do. Let the sound of rejoicing fill our life. Oh God, you have done for us. Oh God, what no man can do. Let the sound of rejoicing fill our life.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come, the hour that we have been waiting for has come. I want to kindly bring to the platform our father, a brother, and a mentor. Like I will always say, he is the one that taught me the art of intercession, how to wait in the place of prayer and intercede for nations, for families, and all sorts. He's a man that I know. He's the first pastor that I was under when I joined the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And God has been using him in diverse kinds of ways to bring joy to so many families, even members of his church, and everyone that have gone through him. I want us to make welcome our brother, our father in the Lord, Pastor Wole Abiola, as he has been here before, and most of you have met him, and you have been under his ministration. I want to trust God that this morning, God is going to do something very outstanding through his ministration in our lives in the name of Jesus. And every story that we have been known for, unpleasant story, the Lord is going to turn them around this morning, and it's going to be turned to glory. In the name of Jesus. Over to you, over to you, sir. Pastor Wale, are you in the house? Hallelujah. Over to Pastor Wale, sir. You are welcome. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you can mute yourself in the next 1 minute, can I hear the voice of everyone on the platform? Yes, wherever you are, all over the places, I can see quite a number of participants from Nigeria, from all over the world, and I'm highly excited. Can they shout a very loud hallelujah? Oh, that's glorious. Wherever we are, can we lift up our voice to the Almighty God? We give you all the glory. We give you honor. We give you all the glory. We give you honor. Hallelujah. We give you all the glory. We give you all honor. honor. You are Yahweh. 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 Alpha Omega. Yahweh, Alpha Omega. May the name of the Lord be glorified in our lives in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, thank you. Yes, we can unmute ourselves. We'll be going into one prayer or two in John chapter 17, verse 1. I've come. Hallelujah. I've just been unmuted. Can we please lift up our voice wherever we are and pray a very simple prayer? Jesus said, the hour has come. Father, glorify yourself. I want us to pray wherever we are. Oh Lord, glorify yourself in my life this morning. Please, Daddy, glorify yourself. The opposite of glory is shame. Lord, enough of shame in my life, enough of embarrassment in my life, enough of humiliations in my life. My Father, my God, glorify yourself in my life. Glorify yourself. Glorify yourself in my life. Enough of embarrassment. Enough of story. Lord, glorify yourself in my life. Glorify yourself in my own. Glorify yourself in my family. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I pray for everyone that are listening to me. The name of God shall be glorified in our lives in the name of Jesus. I want to appreciate God for this great opportunity that he has given unto us, even to minister to us once again. I'm not taking it as a privilege. I'm very, very grateful to my very good brother, Pastor and Pastor Mrs. Richard Edomo. The Lord will continually honor you in the name of Jesus Christ. And to everyone, all the ministers of God that are on this platform, I count it as a privilege to stand before the great men and women of God to be used to minister. Like they said in our climb here, Kilomodimo, what does a small child know? But I know that the name of God who has called us into the ministry shall be glorified in the name of Jesus Christ. We are not not having so much time, the theme of this prayer meeting is a glory out of story. Glory out of story. And I am praying for somebody. It doesn't matter how unpleasant to hearing your story may be. Glory will come out of that story in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible text we are going to be using is the book of Genesis chapter 1. And actually, that is the book of the beginning. In Genesis chapter 1 from verse 1 through verse 3, the Bible says, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, let there be light, and there was light. Now we quickly jump to verse 31. The Bible says, and God saw everything that he had made. And behold, it was very good. And the evening and the morning were the sixth day. Oh my God. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless the reading of his words in the name of Jesus. It is not a coincidence that we are meeting today the sixth day. Several years ago, the Bible said, and it was actually the sixth day. Wherever you are, can you please talk to the Almighty God? My Father and my God, the miracle of the sixth day, the glory of the sixth day, let it manifest in my life. Let it manifest in my marriage. The Bible said, on the sixth day, God saw glory out of story. God saw glory out of story. My Father and my God, out of the story of my life, out of the story of my hope, out of the story, out of the unpleasant story of my life, Baba, let me see glory. Let me see. Let me see glory in this day, in this week, in this month, in this year. Let glory come out of my story. People have known me with story. Baba, let them identify me with glory in the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting King of glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Now, the Bible says in the beginning, now to God, God is the one that has been evil before the beginning. My God has been in existence before the beginning. And that is why to a child of God, God can turn every moment, any moment of his life to a new beginning. I don't know how old you are. I don't know what you have gone through. There is a God that can turn wherever you find yourself to a new beginning. And I want you to cry to the Almighty God and say, my Father, let this program bring about a new beginning in my life. Use this program to initiate a new beginning. Use this program to initiate a new beginning in my life, a new beginning in my home, a new beginning in every areas of my life. Father, use this program. You are the God of the beginning. You are the one that has been in the beginning, even before the beginning began. Lord, I ask, Lord, this morning, you will give my life a new beginning. You will give my home a new beginning. In the name of Jesus Christ, thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I know you are praying. I want you to cry to the Almighty God and say, Father, please repeat a creative miracle in my life. I need creative miracle. The Bible says in the beginning, God created. It was actually a creative miracle. There are many of our situations that what we need now is a creative miracle. In John chapter 9, that man came, he escaped but without eyes, and Jesus encountered him. He said, why is it that this man had no eyes? Before that day was over, this man got a creative miracle of two brand new eyes. Can we pray to the Almighty God? That creative miracle that my life need, that creative miracle that my life need, that will change my story to glory, that will change my story to glory. Lord, let it happen in my life now. Let it happen now. Let it happen now. What no doctor can do, what no man can do, it is a creative miracle. You created the heaven and the earth. Do creative miracle in my life in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The Bible says God created the heaven and the earth, meaning that our God is a God of orderliness and not the God of disorderliness. I want you to cry to God wherever you are. Whatever the enemy has disorganized in my life, oh Lord, stretch your hand of order and let them be reordered. Whatever the enemy has disorganized in my life, whatever the enemy has disorganized in my life, you did not create the earth before the evil. You made the evil before the earth. That is God of orderliness. That is how you arrange it. If the enemy has tampered with my life, Lord, let that be a reorder. Let that be a reorder. Let that be the other. Let that be the other. In the name of Jesus, thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. We are going to cry to the Almighty God. The Bible said there was confusion everywhere. There was no direction. But suddenly God arose. We are going to cry to God and pray to God. Oh Lord, arise and put direction into my life. And put direction into my life. In the journey of life, if I be stranded, oh Lord, redirect me. Redirect me. I must not be stranded in the journey of life. Whatever problem, whatever situation, whatever trouble that make my life to be ending to a destination without a direction. Lord, I ask this morning, give my life a direction. Give my home a direction. Give my marriage a direction. Give my career a direction. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. We are going to cry to the Almighty God and say, my Father, let something great come out of what my belittle, my despise, my mob lie. In the name of Jesus, I don't know the situation that you are. Are people mocking you? Are you being despised? Are you being reproached? Can you cry to the Almighty God? The Bible says, and behold, can you say, look at it? It is visible. It cannot be hidden. Can you cry to God? My Father and my God, let something visible come out of that my situation. That situation of mockery, that situation of despair, that situation of removal, of reproach, that situation of mockery, that situation of shame. Let something great come out. Let something great come out in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The Lord will answer prayer. Father, we quickly go to your word. Lord, please speak to us. In the name of Jesus, the entrance of your word gives light. Lord, to every dark areas of our life, Father, please let there be light in the name of Jesus. Now, from the passage, sir, the Bible says God is it. There is no argument like that. The mystery that actually minister in song, the Lord will bless you, sir. There's no controversy. You are God from beginning to the end. The Bible says from that chapter that we read, it says, in the beginning, God created the heaven, and something must be established, sir. He said, God is the creator of all things. Now, sir, we are not victim, we are not product of evolution. We did not migrate from generation of God created the heaven and the earth and everything. It is only a fool, according to Psalm 14 verse 1, that we say there is no God. I know because you believe that there is God, that same God will do something unusual in your life in the name of Jesus. That same God will do something unusual in your home, in your marriage, in your finance, in your career, in the name of Jesus Christ. I refuse to be a fool because I believe in your creative ability. If you don't believe in God's creative ability, he may not be able to do anything tangible in our life. God created the heaven before the earth, like I told us in the prayer, that God is a God of orderliness. In our home, he wants order. In our marriages, he wants order. In our businesses, he wants order. And that is why I am praying for somebody today. Every spirit of confusion that is controlling your life today, their time is up in the name of Jesus. I said their time is up in the name of Jesus. Now, looking at the story, now let's look at the story. The creation, the Bible says God created, and they now began to paint it as if God does not know what he was doing. The earth was without form. It was shapeless. It was indescribable. It was just like an amoeba in our secondary school biology, something without any shape, something without any that we are, how can we describe the thing? It was empty. It was unfilled. There were vacuum everywhere. Bible says that there were darkness. Oh my God. In the creative work of God and darkness still appear, we should know that darkness stands for the devil. So Satan was even there at the creation. He said there was no light. That Satan, I'm very sure that Satan, as long as there was darkness, Satan was having a free day. He was having fall to the extent that the Spirit of God was moving upon the face of the deep. Actually, God's Spirit dwells in people, but there is nowhere that Spirit could dwell as at that time. Oh, that is the picture. That is the story. It was painted as if God does not know what he's doing. And I know as at that moment, Satan will be happy. Satan will be somewhere mocking God. Oh, can you see what you have done? There is no direction. There is darkness. There is no shape. There is no edgeway. There is nothing that you have been, but suddenly, somebody says, suddenly, God appeared, God arose. I am praying for somebody today. It doesn't matter how directionless your life may be. It doesn't matter how hopeless your situation may be. It doesn't matter how helpless your situation seems to be. My Father will arise for you this morning to bring out glory out of that story in the name of Jesus. We can conclude by saying, oh, it was a pathetic story, that the earth was without form. It was without void. That God's Spirit has nowhere to rest. There was darkness. Satan was in charge. But suddenly, my Father, suddenly, the Bible says, and God arose. And God arose and spoke. And God arose and speak. I pray today to the situation of somebody listening unto me, that Lord will speak to that situation in the name of Jesus. That Lord will speak to that your hopeless situation, that your helpless situation in the mighty name of Jesus. Is there someone listening to me this morning? And your situation describe the situation above, describe what is happening in your life. I don't know how old you are. It's like nothing meaningful is happening, and you are a subject of mockery and ridicule. God is about to do something that will silence your enemies in the name of Jesus. I pray for you wherever you are, that miracle that silences the enemy, that Lord will wrought it in your life, in your situation, in the name of Jesus. Brother, may I tell you today, in all of this situation, my Father knew where he was going. God knows where he was going. God knows what he wanted to do. It doesn't matter the mockery of the devil. It doesn't matter the humiliation. It doesn't matter the beatment. It doesn't matter the demeaning situation. It doesn't matter the satanic comment. God knew where he knew what he wanted to do. And what he wanted to do was, yes, at the extreme of the devil. Now God will now spring up a surprise. And the Bible says, and God arose and spake. He spoke only a word, and there was a turnaround. I am speaking to the destiny of somebody today. This word that you are hearing this morning will bring about a turnaround in your life, in your situation, in the name of Jesus. Bible said, let there be light. And God said, let there be light. As at that moment, yes, there was light. He knew that what the situation needed as at that time, it was light. Can I pray for somebody today? That's your situation. What is needed to turn it around? It will happen in the name of Jesus. He knew that what the situation needed was light, not any other thing, not any other thing, not any other thing. There are many of our situations that we know what they need, but how to get it, we don't know. All powers belong to God. Wherever you are, can you lay your hands upon your head and cry to him and say, my Father, what my situation need, not what I feel it need, what doctor felt it need, my Father and my God, oh yeah, do it now. What my situation need, what my situation need, Lord, do it in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Immediately, the light appeared, the story changed, and it kept changing. The story kept on changing. As God speak, the situation changes. I pray for you today. Your situation will not stop changing until glory has come out of that situation in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, and God shall perfect everything that concerns me. If your amen will run like thunder, wherever you are, in this month of February, February, within the next 7 days, my Father will perfect everything that concerns your life in the name of Jesus. Wherever you are, can you cry unto God? Because it is a prayer summit. Say, Father, before this year is over, let glory come out of my story. Before this week is over, let glory come out of my story in the name of Jesus. Let glory come. Let glory come. Let glory come out of my story. Let glory come out of my stories. Let glory come out of my story. Let glory come out of my story. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I'm very sure wherever you are, I know you are praying. I know you are praying. While I was preparing the message, something came to my mind that what faces somebody determines how that person will pray. If you can pray with all your heart today, that God, who is not the respecter of person, will answer that prayer in the name of Jesus. The way Anna prayed at Shiloh was not the way other women that had a children were praying. The way Jabez prayed was not the way other people pray. I pray to you today. I don't know what you are facing. I don't know what is facing you. As you cry to the Almighty God, Bible says right from the time of John the Baptist, up till now, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violence taken by force. As you are spiritually violent today, there shall be testimonies upon testimonies in your life in the name of Jesus. What is a story? They are mostly unpleasant situations that one is going through, or you have gone through the situation, the express of which at times comes with tears. It comes with sorrows. It comes with weeping. Oh, my Father, the period of one story is that phase where Satan rejoices over one seemingly helpless and hopeless situation. That was a story. The situation that you are helpless, the situation that you are hopeless, the situation that nothing seems to be happening, the situation, oh, I have prayed, I have prayed, I have fasted, but nothing seems to be happening, sir. It is a period of your story. It is a period of a story. It is a period that you don't know how to do anything. You have planted, you have water, but nothing seems to be happening. It is an unpleasant situation. I've seen people, I've had people sharing their story, and they begin to cry, and they begin to weep, and say, Pastor, yeah, it is a long story. And I come to realization that every long story is a bitter story, is a painful story. I am praying for somebody that is listening to me there. Whatever may be your situation, whatever may be your story, no matter how pathetic, no matter how bitter, no matter how sorrowful, glory will come out of that story in the name of Jesus. Now, not for example, Psalm 40 verse 1. David, that we all love to associate with today, he had several series of phases of story in his life. Now, in Psalm 40 verse 1, David said, I waited patiently on the Lord, and he inclined unto me. A period of story is a period that you are waiting. I don't know what you are waiting for. I don't know what you are waiting for. In the name that is above every other name, your period of waiting is over in the name of Jesus. He said, I waited patiently. Are you waiting patiently for a child? Are you patiently waiting for a spouse? Are you waiting for a job? Are you waiting for an opportunity? That is your period, the period of your story, the period that you are making story, unpleasant period, when nobody is there, when my father forsake me, when my mother forsake me. And David went further, and he brought me up out of the miry clay. Oh my God, out of miry clay, out of the audible pain. That was the period of the story. The period when he was in the miry clay. The period when he was in the audible pain. Can I pray for somebody today? It doesn't matter the miry clay of your life. It doesn't matter the audible pit of your life. I see God bringing you out in the name of Jesus. Psalm 137 verse 1. Oh, my Father, the people of Israel said, by the river of Babylon, there we sat and we wept. by the river, sir. An average human being will not go and stand beside the river, sir. They were forcefully evicted. They were forcefully relocated. And I pray for you that is listening to me. Whatever, wherever the problem of your life has driven you to, I see the hand of God located and breaking you out in the name of Jesus. He said, these are people that were forced comfortable. The people that were eating without knowing what the cause of the food was. He said, now they find themselves by the river of Babylon. They were not there for merrymaking. They were not there for picnic. It's the situation of life that forced them there. My father and my God, every of your children, that the situation of life has forcefully relocated. I ask today, let there be a divine relocation in the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. So the Bible said, by the river of Babylon, there we sat. And we wept, oh my father. People that used to be very active, now situation has forced them to sit down. Sitting down, nothing to do. Weeping, weeping. He said, when we remember Zion, when they remember where they are coming from, is there somebody that is crying there? Is there somebody that is weeping there? You remember where you were coming from, and you look at where you are, and you are weeping. In that your weeping situation, because the Bible says in Psalm 30 verse 5, he said, weeping may tarry with the night, but dread cometh with the morning. In the name that is above every other name, this program will usher in your moment of a new morning, of a new dawn in the name of Jesus. In 1 Samuel chapter 1 verse 6, I am looking at a sample of story. Oh, my father, mommy Anna, there was a stage in her life. There was a moment of story, moment of unpleasant story when she was married. She should be the first wife. But unfortunately, when the husband could no longer wait, he married another wife. And that one kept on having baby like pain. And the only thing they look at this woman, they began to provoke her. They began to make her to vex her. They began to make her to remember that yes, she has no child. It was a period of story in her life, but that moment did not last forever. I prophesy to your life, that situation that you are going through will not be permanent in the name of Jesus. That situation that you are going through, that failure will not be permanent. That sickness will not be permanent. That disappointment will not be permanent. That joblessness will not be permanent. That childlessness will not be permanent. That loneliness will not be permanent in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. So we have them all and on like that. Several stories. Joseph was another example, the man that God gave to Dre, that we are going to be great in life. But that glory did not come. It was story. They sold him from where there was hatred in the family because of his dream, because of his great destiny. He was asked to go and give food to his brethren, but he never returned back to that house. From going to give food, the Bible say they plan to kill him, they change their mind, they treat me inside the pit, somebody spoke to them. They saw their brother. He found himself in the house of Potiphar. From there, he was in slavery. He was a slave. From slavery, they lied against him. From there, he got to the priest. He helped somebody in the priest, and he told that one, "Oh, remember me." That one forgot him. It was a bitter story. It was a bitter story. Can I pray for somebody today? Are people that you have helped, have they forgotten you? Has somebody promised to help you, and you are still there? Languishing in the prison of life, languishing in the slavery of life. God is about to change that story to glory. God is about to bring glory out of that your story in the name of Jesus Christ. The story period is a period of loneliness. So if you are lonely, like nobody is there, it is a period of making a story. It was a period of darkness where you never even knew that time has gone so much. When somebody is in darkness, you don't look at the time. It's a period of hopelessness. It's a period of helplessness. It is at times you can. The Bible says in the book of Job chapter 40 verse 1, it's a man that is born of a woman is of few days, and these few days are full of trouble. Troubles, troubles, stories, the unpathetic one, the troublesome one. Oh, my Father, the heartbreaking story, the unpleasant story, story that we hear, that will make you to cry, story that situation that make you to cook food. At the end, I'm wasting time to cook the food. You say you don't have appetite. That is your period of story making. I prophesy to your life, wherever you are listening unto me, your life will not end as a story. If the story of the creation did not end as a story, and God saw everything that he has made, and behold, they were very good. I can see glorious, I can see great glory coming out of that your situation in the name of Jesus Christ. Now let's talk about glory so that we can go to prayer. I don't know how to describe glory. It is beyond description. I simply look at it as something that is praiseworthy, something that worth celebrating. God was celebrating. God was not celebrating failure. He was celebrating breakthrough. He was celebrating glory. And he said, and behold, he saw. Can I pray for you today? I don't know what you have seen in your life before now. Before the next edition of this program, you will be old. And you will see glory out of that story in the name of Jesus Christ. Glory, it is excellent. It is perfect. It is awesome. Glory is the essence of a thing, the beauty of a thing. What makes somebody, what makes something to be called the name it is called? A car is of no use if it is not moving, if it's not performing. Glory is that thing that God has created in your life, that makes you to radiate, that makes you to shine forth as God. Isaiah chapter 43, Isaiah 43 verse 9 or thereabout. He said, Isaiah 43 verse 7, he said, everyone that are called by my name, I have created them for my glory, or for my praise, for my satisfaction, in the name that is above all name. Glory will come out of your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Something that is praiseworthy. Can we look at a few examples of glory? I feel like praying. The same David that was said in Psalm 40 verse 1, I waited out of the muddy clay. That one now said, and he has also brought me out. Can I pray for you today? I see God bringing you out of your muddy clay. I said, he has put my feet upon the rock, and he has established my song, and he has put a new song in my mouth. If your faith can carry it, receive a new song in your mouth in the name of Jesus Christ. It was taken from grass to grace. Everybody wants to call their children David today. Oh, my Father, I am praying for you today. My Father will take you from your zero level to an hero level in the name of Jesus Christ. In Psalm 126, linking it with Psalm 137, for grace and mercy to God. So 126 come before 137. But the event of 137 happened before 126. He said, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, you are like them that dream. That were the same people that sat by the river of Babylon, and they were weeping, and they were crying, and they that carried them captive, they came to mock them. He said, can you sing unto us one of the songs that you used to sing in Zion? And they said, can we sing? How can we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? I see God putting a new song. Where you don't think you can sing, you will sing there in the name of Jesus Christ. In 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 1, the same Anna, the woman that wept anytime they provoke her. This woman said in verse 1, he said, God has enlarged my mouth over my enemy. Oh, the mother of nothing has become the mother of seven. I pray for you today. Glory will come out of that story in the name of Jesus Christ. Glory will come out of that story in the name of Jesus Christ. In 2 Samuel chapter 6, we know the story of Obed-Edom. This man that David looked, who is supposed to die, only turned cuckoo after the death of Uzzah. Uzzah touched the ark and died. And David was like, this ark cannot go to anywhere. Can we place it somewhere? If that person died, nobody will cry. Nobody will weep. And look at the house of Obed-Edom, a house without a window, a house by the roadside. This man bought the land when he had money, but suddenly there was no money, and the house remained uncompleted. Can I pray for somebody today? By the reason of your journey, this program, every completed project shall be completed in the name of Jesus Christ. And they took the ark to the house of Obed-Edom. And David was waiting. Oh, within the next 8 hours, 2 hours, 10 hours, that somebody must come and report that Obed-Edom has died. First week, second week, third week, fifth week, first month, Obed-Edom did not die. Can I pray for somebody that is listening to me today? Whatever the enemy has programmed to destroy you, they will end up blessing you in the name of Jesus. The Bible says after 3 months, the king got a news that God has blessed Obed-Edom. His story has changed. Before the king can hear that God has blessed you, there is a level of blessing that cannot be hidden. I prophesy to somebody listening to me, that level of blessing that cannot be hidden. Customized miracle. Your place number shall be customized. Your house number shall be customized. Everything about you shall be customized. The king was this when he saw Obed-Edom 1. Oh, come and see this beautiful car. Obed-Edom 2. Obed-Edom 3. Obed-Edom 3. The man that God helped. I can see God helping you in your situation. You will not die in that situation. I command, let glory come out of that your story in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, my Father. Glory be to your name. Beloved, I don't know your situation or your story, but I can assure you, I know of a God who say bring glory out of story. Who say bring glory out of shame. Who say bring laughter out of weeping. Who say bring hope out of hopelessness. I know of God. Say bring out of hopelessness. Are you sitting there with me? Are you alive? Oh, I want my glory. I want glory to come out of my story. Sir, there's always a responsibility. What are you supposed to do for glory to come out of your story? Number one, we need God's involvement in our life. A journey without God is a journey that leads to story. David said in Psalm 23, verse 1, the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. Can you allow God to be involved in our life? In John chapter 5, Peter labored all the night because God was not involved. He was about to go enough to go and share the story of failure. But God came in. Jesus came in and the partner. That partnership was a turnaround. And wherever you are, as you are making up your mind to partner with God tonight, this morning, I can see a great turnaround in your situation, in your life, in the name of Jesus. You need a very strong determination in the place of prayer. A very strong determination. Sir, people are entitled to their opinion about you. But one thing that you should know, nobody has the final say over your life. God has the final say. Sir, it is in the position of man to mock. It is the position of man to humiliate you. That you need to be determined. Thank God for the determination of Anna. I'm very sure Anna was not the only barren woman, but we had a testimony. Thank God for the determination of Jabez. He must not be the only unfortunate man, but he was determined in the place of prayer. Jacob was determined in the place of prayer. At the stage, he was telling God, he said, God, I will not allow you to go, sir. He said, I will not let you go. That is a great determination. Can you be determined this morning at the altar of prayer? It doesn't matter what you have had. It doesn't matter what people have told you. If only you are determined, I can see glory coming out of your story in the name of Jesus Christ. And finally, because I want us to pray, that you need to follow through. There is a following God through. During the crisis period, following God through. The period of crisis is not the period to try another God. You need to follow God through. In Luke chapter 9, verse 62, after everybody has departed from Jesus, Jesus turned to Peter. He said, do you want to go back too? And Peter said, to whom shall we go? We have left everything to follow you. To whom shall we go? You have the word of eternal life. If only because of the word, I am not going anywhere. Sir, you need to follow God through. A servant cannot serve two masters. He said that he ate one and loved the other. Can you hold on unto God? Can you hold on unto God? In life and in death. Apostle Paul said in Romans chapter 8, verse 35, he said, who shall separate me from the love of Christ? Don't allow that problem to separate you, sir. Don't allow that sickness to separate you. Don't allow what you are going through to separate you. Follow God. Can you behave like Ruth, who followed Naomi when she was not even sure that maybe Naomi will have another child? He said, where you go, I will go. Your people shall be my people. Your God will be my God. Where you die, I will die. But brave, glory be to God. Out of that pathetic story of Naomi and Ruth, that was where Jesus came out from. Follow God through. Hold on to him. Don't stop prayer. Somebody said, it is not over, and it is over. And very, very soon, I can see that problem getting over in your life. Children of God, it is time for us to pray. I want us to pray. Few prayer. Can you rise up wherever you are and cry to God, say, Father, thank you because my story is about to change. Thank you, Father. Glory is about to come out of my glory. Sir, there is power in your mouth. God used the creative power in his mouth. He said, let there be light. Oh, my Father, life and death is in the power of the mouth. You have the power in your mouth. Somebody said a closed mouth is a closed destiny. Your destiny will not be short, untimely, in the name of Jesus. Can you say, Father, thank you. Thank you because joy is coming. Thank you because glory is coming. Thank you because laughter is coming. Thank you because celebration is coming. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The first prayer you are going to pray, I want you to cry unto God. Believe me, beloved, God still answer prayer. The creation knew there was a time in my life. The story was the story of barrenness. No children, sir. I was at times that were called that were afraid to pick. But God bring glory out of that story. God disgrace Satan. God disgrace shame. I see God disgracing shame. Power behind the story of your life, they must be disgraced. Can you cry to God and say, my father, every power behind my story, behind my unpleasant story, disgrace them, disgrace them, disgrace them, disgrace them. Brother, open your mouth and pray to the Almighty God. Every power behind my story of sorrow, that story that is not planted. Oh, yeah, disgrace them, disgrace them, disgrace them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father, in Jesus' mighty name. We are praying, brother. You have to follow me. I want to be a little bit fast in this prayer. Prayer number two, we are going to say, Father, let joy come out of my weeping and sorrow. Let joy come out of my weeping and my sorrows. Bring joy, bring joy, bring joy, bring joy out of my weeping. Bring joy out of my sorrow. Bring joy out of my weeping. In the name of Jesus, we are going to cry to God and say, my Father, Father, say, Pastor, Father, please bring help out of my helpless situation. Bring help out of my helplessness. Bring help out of my helplessness. Before this day is over, before this week is over, my Father and my God, bring help out of my helplessness in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The Bible says concerning and enforcement chapter 1 verses. It says God shut our womb. And the same God that shut our womb, open our womb. I don't know that door that is closed against your life. We are going to cry and cry unto God. Of my life, bring open doors of fruitfulness, open doors of breakthrough, open doors of connection out of every closed door in the name of Jesus. The man that they thought we die in poverty, God brought us glory out of that story of poverty. Cry to God, say, my Father, please bring, let prosperity come out of my story of poverty. Let prosperity come out of my story of poverty. Let prosperity come out of my story of poverty. In the name of Jesus, bring prosperity out of my poverty. encounter that changed his life. The Bible said he was washing his net. He was washing his net. Can I talk to somebody? Don't wash your net. Be prepared for a breakthrough. Can you cry to God and say, my father, please bring breakthrough out of my failure. Bring faith. The same place that I failed, let there be breakthrough this year. Where I have failed before now. Where I failed last year. Where I failed. The same business that I did. The same job that I did. The same person that I wrote that I failed. Let there be breakthrough. God that changes that bring glory out of story. Lord, change that story from that of failure to that of breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. We have about two more prayer points. We are going to cry unto God. In Ezekiel chapter 37, the Bible says, and God took me to the valley of dry bone, and God asked the man of God, he said, can this bone live? And the man looked at the bone. He said, God, I don't want to tell you. I don't want to be a pessimist. I don't want to take the negativity. But this situation that I'm looking at is only you that know. And God said, don't worry. Oh, yeah, begin to prophesy. As he prophesied, the end of the story. The Bible says, he said, this are the house of Israel. That said, our hope is gone. That we don't have anything. That this is how we are going to die. But God said, go and tell them, I will open your grave. Today, I see God opening that grave. You are going to cry to the Almighty God. And the Bible says, out of that dry bone, God brought out a great army. Can you cry to God and say, my father, please bring out a great army out of my dry bones. Bring out a great army. Bring out a great army. You have the power. All powers belong to you. Bring out a great army out of my dry bone. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Finally, cry to God. Oh, that woman with the issue of blood for 12 years, she was telling the story of issue of blood. I don't know the issue of your life. I don't know that issue. There are always an issue, but there is a God that can bring testimony out of that story of sickness. Cry to God, say, my father, let there be a testimony. Bring out testimony out of this my situation, out of this sickness, out of this failure, out of this trouble, out of this disease. Bring out testimony. The woman knelt before Jesus Christ and she said, Daddy, I am the one. I have bled for 12 years. What is that issue in your life? Can you cry to the Almighty God as we round up this prayer meeting? I know a God. Yes, I am tired of my valley. I am tired of my story. Oh Lord, take me out of my clay. Set my feet on the solid rock. Take me out of my clay. Set my feet on the solid rock. Thank you, my Father. My Father, my God, I draw my faith to the faith of all your children all over the world, wherever they are, listening to this message. Father, let there be glory out of their stories in the name of Jesus. Let there be glory out of their story. You have done it before. Father, do it again in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. I pray for every family, every individual, every personality that have been part of this broadcast. Daddy, before this month is over, according to the time of life and season, let there be glory out of story. Thank you, Father. Glory be to your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Glory be to God in the highest. Amen. Glory be to God in the highest. Amen. For his mercies endureth forever. Amen. For his mercies endureth forever. Amen. Pastor Richard, thank you. The Lord will bless you. I will hear your testimonies in the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. Thank you for the privilege. Thank you for the honor. The Lord will honor you. See you again in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Over to Pastor Woshika, please. Pastor Wole, thank you very much. The Lord will bless you. And we increase you on our side in Jesus' name. Over to you, Pastor.
We bless the name of the Lord for an awesome time to pray. Pastor, hallelujah. Thank you very much. God will increase you on all sides. Amen. As you have blessed us this morning, the Lord will bless you in return. Amen. We increase you on all sides, and his oil upon your head will never run dry. Amen. In the name Amen. Of Jesus. Amen. It is right and fit for us to appreciate God as well. We have been blessed, I want us to bless God in return. Even while we are on this platform, I want us to minister from what God has deposited into our hands, even unto this particular meeting. Let's sow a seed of faith to seal up all those prayers that we have been blessed with and that we have even prayed by ourselves as we were led. So I want us to package a good and quality offering unto God, even this morning. And as we do that, we bless it, and the name of the Lord shall be glorified, even as we obey in the name of Jesus Christ. You can tag it maps as your reference. Put maps as your reference, as it is displayed on the screen. Maps offering. Maps offering. Let's do that very quickly. Let's do that very quickly. And for those who are abroad that may want to do it, you can minister through this IBAN number that we have put there. The IBAN number is there, and there is reference number. So no one is excluded. Even if you are abroad, you can still do your offering through the IBAN number. Praise God. Well, our Father and our God, we want to thank you for this opportunity to give unto you this morning and to your work. Lord, we ask that you will receive all our offerings in the name of Jesus. Use them for your glory, O God. And in return, bless us mightily in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, continually, anywhere we gather, anywhere we are asked to do this exercise, none of us will be found wanting. In the name of Jesus, you will continually load us with your benefit, and we will not lack anything good. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. We declare great grace upon everyone on the platform, even to this month of February. February is a month of, it's double, like our father-in-law said yesterday. I pray for double blessings over everyone. I pray for double testimonies over everyone. I pray for double deliverances over everyone. I pray for double breakthroughs over everyone in this month of February, in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for double breakthrough, even for the visioner and his family, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We will not die on the way on this journey. Lord, we see us to our expected end, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Shall we share the grace in fellowship? One, two, go. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Good morning, everyone. Have a lovely weekend.
Good morning, everyone. Happy, glorious weekend.
Thank you. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Bye, Lighthouse. Enjoy your weekend. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, everyone.